how come the other four boys weren't even talking to me? If they don't like you, then they don't like you. If I don't like them, then that's it. Yeah. Dead ma. I don't know if I should say this, but yeah.
Oh my God.
Do you have a love life? There's nothing in my brain right now. They were already warned not to talk to me.
Hi, I'm Bria with Kaya, Rain, Anna, and Gia, and you are watching G-Talk.
Will you marry me?
Okay. The essence of a man is to take care of the woman he loves.
I have the perfect marriage to follow.
There is law of attraction.
Sir Gary, there's a show called G-Talk and they... Yep!
Our guest for today is an award-winning Filipina actress.
Her career began in 1982 when she was introduced in a starring role in the teen classics Baguettes.
She's best known for her movies Kiko Boxingero and Metamorphosis.
She is also an influencer and a YouTuber.
Please help me welcome the beautiful Yayo Aguila.
Woo!
Hello! How are you?
Hi, ladies! Hi, beautiful ladies! Hi. I'm so happy to be here. Thank you for inviting me. I'm so excited to be among you beautiful women, and it really makes my day.
Longtime fan here.
Oh my gosh, thank you. Thank you. I'm shy.
Baguette days.
Oh my gosh, really? Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Yes, so welcome to G-Talk. We are so happy to have you on the show.
We wanted to get to know another side of you through our G-Talk's 2-minute fast talk, where we mention words or phrases in alphabetical order, and you respond with only one word that comes to your mind.
Oh my gosh, okay.
So that's 26 questions from A to Z, and it's fast-paced, so whatever comes to your mind, that's what you have to say.
Oh my gosh, I hope I do this right.
Are you all ready?
Right. I'm ready. I think I'm ready.
A, assumptions about you.
Always alive in every conversation.
E for favorite baguettes.
Eula.
C, craziest thing you did for love.
Oh gosh, I didn't go to college.
D, how to handle a diva.
Don't give an F.
E, their most embarrassing moment.
Well, when I had to accept an award and I wasn't even properly dressed.
F, fun fact about you.
I don't act like my age.
G, your go-to karaoke song.
How do I live without you?
H, your most memorable high school experience.
Not going to school to see my boyfriend.
I, if you had to live your life over, what would you change?
Maybe going to college, because I wasn't able to do that.
J, a juicy rumor about you that isn't true.
Oh, that I once had, I was going out with an older man, but that was my stepdad I was with.
K, first impression of Kulit.
Funny.
L, most beautiful local celebrity.
Bea Alonso.
M, a celebrity you are mistaken for.
Bel Mariano and Carmina Villaruel, or sometimes Nadine Lustre. I don't know, they just tell me about it.
N, a childhood nickname that you didn't like.
None.
Oh, note to your 16-year-old self.
Focus on school. School before love.
P, what did you buy with your first paycheck?
Clothes.
Q, the number one questions fans ask you when they see you in person.
How's your love life?
T, tell us something that is not in your resume.
I eat a lot.
S, showbiz then and now.
People were more friendly before and more professional work-wise than now. Sorry, I really had to say that.
T, if your life were a movie, what would the title be?
The Notebook.
U, the most unusual fan request.
There was this male fan who was asking for a video, and you know how it goes.
V, your vanity plate.
I don't know, maybe I'll just put my kids' initials.
W, wackiest thing you have ever done.
When I get surprised, or like I get excited, or like I get gulat, I say the grossest things in front of many.
X, what's an X-Men power you want to have?
I just want to be invisible.
Why? Lowest point in your life?
When I separated from my then husband.
Z, how to friend zone someone?
Oh no, I just don't reply. Like in Tagalog, they say dead ma.
Okay.
So that's dead ma, Lisoka. Bye.
At least something, a new word for our millennials here.
Yes, that's right.
I think that's the secret of your being ageless. You said that you don't have your age, but you don't look your age. So,
oh my gosh. Thank you guys.
Yeah, your attitude is so nice.
Super. I'm always like this, you know, because it's already so stressful. So the least I can do is just smile and be happy. And I hope that I keep others happy, you know. Smile is contagious.
What would be your 30-day comfort challenge?
You know what? It's like every day is like a 30-day challenge for me because I don't eat rice. And I have been a rice eater. You know how we Filipinos are, we live on rice alone. But I haven't eaten rice for like years. But on cheat days, I don't eat like a cup of rice. I just like maybe take a few spoonfuls and that's it. So maybe that's, I can say it's the rice challenge. Because it's so hard to eat ulam without rice. But now I try to eat like maybe once every 2 weeks. I try the different kinds of rice. Rice is rice. Can't live without rice.
Talk to us about baguettes. So you were in this hit movie and I read somewhere that all the male actors wanted to court you. So how did it feel, you know, getting all that attention?
You know how they say in Tagalog ang haba ng hair ko, because you know when you hear about that, there's so much excitement in you. But then when that was happening, I just turned 16, and you know it was fun when I found out about it. I was so kilig.
Were they trying to compete for your attention, and what did they do?
They kept talking about it because one wanted to court me and the other one wanted to call me. But then my ex-husband, being the eldest guy in the group, he took over and he told everybody, no one's gonna talk to her, no one's gonna even touch her or go near her. That's what happened.
And then he fell in love with you by protecting you.
Yeah. Exactly. That's what happened when I got to the set and I had to shoot the film with him because he was my partner. That's why I was wondering, how come the other four boys weren't even talking to me? And then I found out afterwards that they were already warned not to talk to me.
What was it that you said about show business being different back in the day than it is now? What do you think?
Oh, yeah, because before, there weren't that many actors and actresses. It was very simple compared to now. There wasn't even technology back then. So everyone was friendly. Everyone was working professionally. Everyone was courteous, polite. But now it's sad to say that there's a lot of people who are not like that. Now it's a bigger workplace. So much people in the set. You have to really adjust. You have to make friends with everybody. It's not like someone's going to approach you and introduce you. But that's how it should really work, right? You should be the one to, like, you know, make friends with everybody. But not everyone's like that right now. And maybe because it's a fast-paced world we live in, everyone's like in a hurry. Everyone's competing with each other. But I'm happy. I'm not complaining. It's a blessing to meet new people every day at work. It's a blessing to get to work with other people and you learn from them. And that's what matters. If they don't like you, then they don't like you. If I don't like them, then that's it. Yeah. Remember, Deadma. Yes. If you don't like someone, then just you can just sit in your own little corner and just talk to yourself.
I want to know more about that rumor that you said. They thought that you were on a date and then you're with your stepdad.
Yeah. That happened so many times when my stepdad, he used to really always bring me to hotels. Like, he loves eating at coffee shops, like hotel coffee shops, because he's pretty. He was pretty old then. You know how dads are, yeah. Diba? So I was already married. This happened a few years before he passed away. He would always bring me to hotels, and we would always avail of the buffet because he loves to eat. After a few weeks, I was in a couple of news articles that I was dating an older man.
Yeah.
Of course, that was my stepdad, and we didn't really look alike. To add to that, I was also always with my best friend, and my best friend, well, she doesn't look like as girly as I do. You know, people would always gossip about, and they would say I was going out with another girl.
Oh my gosh,
That was my best friend of like many years since first year in high school. But I'm used to, you know, people saying this and that. So you really just have to let it go.
Going back to love, not sure. Are you going out with anybody now?
Now I can say that I'm happy. I'm inspired. I wake up every day with a smile. I go to bed with a smile.
There's a twinkle in your eye.
Yeah. My cheeks are blushing, ba? And I thank God every day that there's someone. Oh my gosh, this is the first time I'm saying this. Wow. And I'm glad I'm saying this, not in the Philippines.
Thank you for sharing that.
Yes. This is the first time.
Congratulations.
Thank you. And I'm not afraid to share it with you guys.
Don't worry, it won't leave this room.
Yeah, and kasi I'm happy to share it with you guys kasi lahat, we're all girls here. So, you know how we all girls when we get together.
I saw a post of yours, I think you posted it on Facebook. The first time you won an award, you know, and you were saying that it took so long and finally you're recognized. Take us back to that time.
That was a very long post I did 2 days after I received that award. 2 days. Why 2 days? Because really, I stayed in my room for 2 days. I didn't get out of my room because I was trying to process everything. Because at my age, that was what, 4 years ago? So that was when I was 50. Okay, that was like a milestone for me because I've been in the business for more than 30 years. And, you know, it wasn't really like on top of my list to get an award. Obviously, it's every actor's dream. I just wanted to go and work and concentrate on my craft and, you know, like improve myself every day. But then that came along and it was just Kiko Boxing Era was just a very quiet and simple movie. It, you know, when I got that award, I tried to process everything. And then I remembered the many rejections I had along the way. And then I found out about people not believing in me. You know, like I was being casted in a few shows and projects, but then I heard that I was getting rejected and they were choosing somebody over me. So you know how it is in the business. It was really a tough journey. But then when I got that award, everything, like I just processed everything and I said, oh, okay, maybe this is my time. I prayed a lot, prayed that I would get the best project, I would get to work with the best people, and then I did. So, but you know, at the end of the day, all you can do is just be thankful and be grateful for everything that's coming your way.
What did you do exactly inside the room? Were you crying?
I cried and I was thinking about those people who rejected me and I was praying for them. The only times I would leave the room was to go to the kitchen and eat, and then I would go back, and then my kids were like wondering what I was doing. I just didn't want to talk to them. I isolated myself because it was so hard for me to absorb everything, because you know, at first I thought, oh my gosh, I didn't deserve it. But then after like reflecting on so many things, I realized, yeah, I deserve this. God gave this to me because, you know, it was a reward for the hard work that I've done.
Screaming at the pillow?
Maybe I was. But I did everything. I jumped on the bed. My face was on the window and I was like looking out. It was like a music video. Like you're crying and then you're thinking of so many things and there's music playing in the background.
What was the thing that helped you push more and like not give up?
Because you know what? At some point, we really have to believe in ourselves. At my age, I've been through a lot. And then there were points in my life where I was doubting myself. I didn't really believe in myself. Mm-hmm. But I had to work because I had to put food on the table because I have kids. For me, as far as I'm concerned, it was okay to not believe in myself because that pushed me to really do believe in myself. Because when I was going through so much, I just prayed a lot, and then I realized, oh, God gave me so much blessing that I need to look forward to and not just dwell on whatever bad that was happening to me. So there's so much turning point in my life, and I'm thankful for everything. I'm thankful that I separated from my ex-husband because it made me stronger. It made me a better woman, and I realized that I could do so many things even on my own. We women empowerment here, you know. We can do so much on our own. And as the oldest here in this group, I'm telling you now, based from my experience, guys, you know, you push, do what you want to do what's going to make you happy and what's going to give you success. That is what's important. I've been a single mom for 14 years now, and I've discovered so much about myself. And we can all do so much, even on our own.
Thank you so much for sharing that story. You know, Yayo, you deserve everything that has come your way.
Yes.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Congratulations on all your success, Yayo.
Thank you.
With a career that spans almost 4 decades, you've probably seen it all and probably found yourself in a valley where all is uncertain, but you kept on going. By being persistent, you demonstrated faith. Because if you didn't have faith, you wouldn't have persisted. And we leave you with this quote by James N. Watkins: "A river cuts through a rock not because of its power, but because of its persistence." Thanks for watching.